Okay, guys. I just had a brain fart. What were we just doing? It seems like there's been several years or several weeks that have gone past, and
4 weeks.
Wow. No, what? I was in character.
Oh. Yeah. Oh yeah, 4 weeks. Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
And we're still here. What was I playing again? A Blood Ranger. That's right.
Kitsune. I mean, human. Totally.
Oh wait, I'm GMing? When did that happen?
What the fuck is this paper? It has a bunch of numbers and shit on it.
Yep.
When's Rise of the Rune Lords coming back? Anyway.
Alright. So, heading down into one of the tunnels.
Chomp, 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 chomp.
Go to the one on the left first. That's where you'll be going.
Wait, like,
guys.
Our left or the token's left? Okay.
I mean, you don't really go, because I moved you.
Okay.
Oh.
But, yeah.
So what the hell were you telling us that...
I feel like someone just picked me up and put me down someplace else, guys.
Did you just put me in a box, motherfucker?
What are you two going on about?
Okay. So y'all can adjust your marching order any way you want. This is how I stuck y'all in here, because you've gone in this order before.
Alright. Blood Rager on... Yeah. Blood Rager on point, I'll back you up, Bard in the middle, Healer on rear guard.
Okay.
Singing a Bard song, singing a Bard song.
Graves are all that ran away.
I didn't!
Oh, right.
The danger of it is okay.
As you travel down in this tunnel, the air starts to get more damp, the stench of decay. So, go on ahead.
Okay.
What you gonna do?
No, probably should do a quick check for any other pits or whatnot that might come out of nowhere.
Oh, yeah. Perception. Sorry.
What's the likelihood of us ever running into traps? Ever.
What's a trap?
Exactly.
I got a 23 perception.
You don't say anything.
There it is.
Alright. In that case, I'm going to continue forward.
19 in perception. Just
no, I didn't see anything. We know he's a Damphir.
There's a clear. There's a giant poster above his head that says Damphir.
Okay.
A pasty white elf.
I mean, all elves are kind of pasty looking.
Hey! And you are surrounded by 3 skeletons.
Yep.
You got the drop on.
Alright.
Front to back, what you doing? Front to back, what you doing? Siegfried first.
Alright. So, I'm going to immediately charge this one up here.
Alright.
Wait, the Damphir's dead, or he's...
He's dead.
He's dead.
He's lying on the ground, and he's been chewed on, so...
Okay.
So, yeah.
So... There's no ambiguity here.
No, he's dead.
Okay.
We don't need to, like, check for his pulse or anything.
Like, Damphirs have a pulse.
Yes.
They're not vampires, dude.
But they react to...
They're just half vampires.
Either way. Okay, so charging, not raging yet, because these are just skeletons.
Oops. They're completely just missed the box. Where did that go?
11.
16.
Yes.
Alright. Raging, I mean, does charging go towards damage as well, or only attack?
Just attack.
Yeah. So... nice. That's 14.
Goes down.
Awesome.
Next.
Alright.
Vitala.
I'm fanning out this way. Did I just walk into a stalactite, or...?
No.
Alright.
You totally walked into a stalactite.
Totally.
Alright. And, I'm gonna fuck his day up.
Well, he's a skeleton. I'm not sure how much more fucked up we can get.
Do we have fate points?
No.
Alright.
Ooh.
Wow.
Ooh.
Alright.
Shit.
See, now what... See, now, if a roll like that, I'm reminded of the meme that's passed around the Pathfinder page, where the skeleton gets a pitchfork between his spine. He just goes, alright, now you're just being a dick.
So I got a 1.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you miss.
Alright.
Alright. Bard, you're up.
Do-do-do-do-do, fighting skeletons! Wah!
Alright, everybody gets plus 1.
Alright.
Yay.
Lynn's going to just...
Do something, you bard!
I am!
Alright. Roll initiative.
Ow. 25.
Alright. 21 for me.
13?
Hits.
The other attack is a 17.
It hits.
Alright, so, let's see, that would be 4d4 plus 2.
Up.
quick sidestep from the attack and using the leverage to swing my sword down. That's a 13 to hit.
It misses.
And I miss as well.
Alright. Keone.
Sing a song.
Sing a song. Alright.
You're the piano man?
Totally the piano.
Greg's
man.
Going to step up and take a swing.
I've got a giant piano on my back that I whip out and I start playing.
Yes, they're sharing a drink known as
goes down.
They're sharing a drink known as loneliness, called but it's loneliness. Better than drinking alone.
So, everything died.
I've been told a lot. Oh,
you just killed our cleric.
Oops. Sword and a ring both seem to have some type of aura.
Would that be spellcraft or knowledge arcana?
Could be either one.
My spellcraft is actually higher, so I'm going to check the sword first. We got a 10? Turns out to be how I give you the long sword anyway.
What was it you used?
A spellcraft, and I got a 10.
Okay.
And I got a higher roll to check the ring.
Tooltip says unidentifiable.
I hover the mouse over it. What do you hold? What secrets do you hold, Longsword? Are you being given out by strange women in a lake?
Maybe.
Okay. Well, it's a plus one Longsword in the Ring of Protection.
Cool.
Alright, so I'm going to give you the long sword, since you're the fighter.
Thanks. I'll be sure to hold on to it.
You're able to use it while we're on this journey. It's a plus one long sword.
Long sword deals 1d8 damage, plus one. My normal weapon.
You get a plus one to your attack and your damage roll, yeah.
Could I wield it?
Technically, yeah.
Actually, because the weapon I use uses dexterity to attack, not strength. I mean...
Oh, strength.
It still works.
You'd be able to defend yourself, at least.
weapon finesse would work on a longsword.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
So I'll give the bard the longsword.
So what was it again?
It's a plus one longsword. It's an additional point to your attack roll and your damage roll, and it does a d8 plus strength to damage. And the Ring of Protection, who amongst us has the lowest AC? I got a 17.
16.
She gets it.
Okay. So now you get a point of AC.
Alright.
Waffles for the bard!
Woohoo!
We did good, so we get waffles?
Yep.
I like waffles. So, 1 AC.
Yep.
Mess with
so,
this now. Okay,
moving on. I'll go back and say, hey dude, we cleared it. Cool. Alright, so you go on to the next one.
Awesome. Checking for pits or traps or anything again. That is a 24 on perception.
You don't see anything.
Alright. And I shall continue forward to here.
Alright.
To see what happens when I look into that seemingly open area.
You see.
Wasn't there a hole in the other room?
No.
No.
Okay. No, the hole was back in the cave entrance. That took us a few minutes to figure out how to get across.
Gotcha.
Alright.
Oh, shit.
Down this way, the walls are coated with an omnipresent bioluminescent fungi. There are different branches as you go down, but they're either too narrow, or they just circle around, or there's been cave-ins for them. About 20 minutes down, you get down to this area. The persistence glow of the bluish fungi dimly lights the way deeper below the Cortos Mountains. The tunnel broadens to reveal a shallow river that bisects an immense tunnel stretching to the north and south. To the east, a small passage exits the chamber at a steep incline, and you see two kobolds.
Hey, Claire, did we just come down to the river to pray? There we go.
I'm missing the joke.
It's a hymn.
Oh, okay.
As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear starry crown, good Lord, show me the way.
I start singing that. Oh, brothers, let's go down. Let's
so there's
go down.
Have the kobolds seen to notice us yet?
They have seen you.
Damn.
Down. They're not doing anything yet, though.
Well, kobolds are normally kleptomaniacs.
Hello! How's it going?
Are we doing a baptism service?
I am hiding my coin purse.
Okay.
They're on the other side of a river.
You never know what coin purse.
Well, it's a very shallow river. It's only about a foot deep.
So, like, crossing it, they're just kind of rough terrain, not as...
Yeah.
Okay.
Not really even that.
Okay.
So you said that there is a steep incline to the south, and what else?
Over here.
If we move into the room.
Right over here is the exit.
So we have
to... I mean, we don't have to exit that way. You could, but...
It seems to be our only way.
I mean, we could just go out the way we came. I mean, it's just that way.
I know, but we have to explore these caves, which means we have to keep going that way.
goes out.
Someone keeps putting me in back.
No, you're just not moving. They look at each other and start talking.
What are they saying?
I thought you would know.
Can you understand them?
Sylvan?
What do they speak? I think they have their own language, don't they?
I think they speak Draconic, too.
Yeah. Aww.
Dang it.
The only sentence I know in Draconic is how much are turnips.
Yep, Draconic.
How much are turnips?
How much are turnips?
It depends on the season.
Yeah.
Where?
I guess they'd be more in the winter than, yeah, say, spring.
They generally flux between, like, 3 and 5 coppers.
Yeah, they're jabbering at each other.
Where? Because the funny thing is, every time I create a character, I always choose Draconic as an extra language just for the hell of it. But then again, I have an intelligence modifier of 0, so all I know are Common and Elven.
Yep. Hold on.
That's why I don't know what it now.
When do you get bonuses for an intelligence modifier? Because I have an intelligence modifier of 2, and I only know 2 names. How many more?
100.
2 more languages? Whoa. So I would know, 4 languages? Oh, man. Okay, I will pick those out.
That's right, we're going through the middle of character creation in the midst of an adventure.
You want to pick Draconic? So you totally know Draconic, right, Bart?
I'll go with Sylvan and Aquin.
Actually, knowing her background, it would be Draconic.
So but what are they saying, Bard?
I could choose something else, or I could just say, hey, I don't know right now, I'm having,
So does this nullify everything you were doing for Pathfinder?
No.
This is okay.
They're too far away, you can't hear them.
Okay.
But then one pulls out a sling.
Hey, that one pulled out a sling! I think they're about to attack!
Yes, I get that.
Does a 17 hit Siegfried?
Since we would be flat-footed, yes.
Alright.
We haven't acted, so yeah.
Siegfried takes 2 damage.
Ooh. Oh no!
Roll initiative.
That's called the GM waiting too long, kids.
Are the players waiting too long?
That too, yeah.
So we're just standing over here yelling at them. Yeah.
That's, what the hell is that? 9.
Nah.
16.
I should probably look up available languages and get that.
A manly 6!
20!
Well, there's the basics. Elven, Dwarven, Gnomish. And then there's ones like Undercommon, which is the language of the Drow. Draconic.
Everyone needs to speak Aquin. For no other reason than no one speaks Aquin.
Infernal, which is the language of demons. Astral, which is the language of gods and angels.
I thought that was Celestial.
Celestial, yes.
Why are there differences for angels and celestials, and it's stupid.
You mean, why do the heavens have their own language?
No, why do they have different languages?
Cool. They don't, it's just celestial.
You go skill descriptions under linguistics, it's got the list.
No?
gnoll, which is kind of a dog-like race. Cat language.
Ah!
So,
okay, so first up is Tia. You're up.
You get to sing your song
first. Everybody gets a plus one! Surprise!
Having bards in the group is awesome!
Siegfried!
But I got a six.
But not Siegfried. Oh,
yeah.
That's all.
Alright. Let's see what type of distance it would be to get there. I'd have to take two move actions.
You won't be able to... Oh, yeah. Never mind.
This is the one that threw the...
Yes.
...thing? Alright. So, I take...
Charge work?
I suppose it could work.
No, you wouldn't be able to charge through the...
Alright, so I'm just going to take two moves to get up there and put him in my threatened area.
And you're going to pause here. Does 27 hit you?
Yes.
Okay. You take 3 points of damage, and I need a fortitude save.
3 points of damage.
Eggman.
So we're learning
that. You can continue.
We're learning not to go into the water.
What happened in the water?
Something you didn't go in the water, you got hit by a dart. There's a dart right there. It was a trap. Right.
Let's see. So
tart! There's tart!
You were too far back, but you didn't have to check to catch that one.
They're tarps.
Alright. 13?
Makes it.
Alright.
Alright, next up is Kobolds.
Now, because that trap is triggered, it's not going to trigger, say, for anyone else who's charging across the river?
Nope.
Alright.
Yay!
I assume a 5 does not hit.
No, it does not.
Or a 4.
Probably not.
Siegfried's up.
Wait, did they just do a ranged attack in my threatened area? Or...
No, he's moving up to you. They have spears as
okay.
well as slings.
Alrighty.
Yeah.
You could also use that. It's like a...
Same thing. Or wait.
Like, plate.
That is an amazing idea.
Yeah, same thing.
Yeah.
I'm going to do that.
Alright. So I'm going to double move to also get up there with him.
Okay.
Her. Show some respect for Atala.
To the water's edge, at least.
Yeah. Thank you. There. Is that good? Or more up?
That's fine. Yep, I can perceive it there. So. Next up is
acoustics.
Alright. I'm going to attack that guy twice. There it is. Does a 14 hit?
It does not.
Does a 16 hit?
It does.
Alright. So, 2d4 plus 1. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do We were getting a plus one from the music?
Yes.
So that means that that 14 would actually be a 15. With a 15?
It does.
Alright, then another 2d4 damage.
Okay, he's dead.
Oh, okay. So.
Goes down, yeah. So this one is down. So the other one attacks. Misses.
Awesome. Raging, just gonna swing. Swing away. 7 plus 4. 11? No.
No.
Okay. I'm done.
Attack the one in front of Siegfried.
Alright.
I'm going to attack it twice. Let's see, that'd be 12 plus 2, so that 14 would not hit.
Don't forget the plus 1.
Plus 1.
I know, I figured that one in. But
it does not hit then.
I'm assuming a 22 would.
Yeah.
Alright.
That would.
Alright, 2d4 plus 1. 8 points of damage.
It goes down.
Alrighty.
Lit bodies.
You find nothing of interest.
The slope just goes up and out, or...
Yeah, do you think it probably would eventually lead you back out of the cave? So do you want to go that direction, or do you want to go back and see the Gillman?
Well, weren't there other passages we needed to check out?
Those were the two.
We can stick our heads out and see where we are.
It's quite a ways down.
Let's go back to the Gilman.
Yeah.
Right.
Times like that, I wish my Touch of Destiny ability was a minor action instead of a standard.
Okay, so. Back at the Gilman. Yuri, his name was.
So, hey, we cleared out those side passages. Down that way, she points towards where Siegfried is now with the stairs. It turns out that there was a man, specifically a Damphir, that was trying to somehow build up some sort of offensive force against the nearby town. And he was trying to use a deceased Gilman to do it. Turns out it backfired on him.
The skeletons were eating him.
He sighs. So that's where they went. Thank you for taking care of that.
But down the other passage, it came to a small stream, really. And we encountered some kobolds down there. We think they may have come in from... another more vertical entrance that came down to the cave system.
Interesting. I wonder what they were doing there.
We didn't really find out.
Anyway, thank you for taking care of that. Now, this you see before you, you've already deduced, is a model of Absalom. Would you like me to assist you in the rituals that you discovered earlier?
Yes.
All right. So, let's see. Let me pull that up real quick. All right. So, one of them you found was a fisherman. The fisherman is depicted hauling an enormous catch of small fish to take back to Absalom, illustrating Aridan's declaration that a great host of creatures could accomplish a great task, whether that be taming the wilds or feeding a nation. Yuri tells you that in order to complete this ritual, you must catch one of the blind cave fish swimming in the pool and place it in the city.
That sounds simple enough.
Keone immediately starts trying to catch the blind cave fish.
Okay, and he rolls.
How? What?
Just a d20. It's an unarmed strike.
7.
You miss it.
So I'm splashing around in the water.
Anyone else?
Would it be a survival check to fish?
No, it's just...
Just an unarmed attack?
Yes.
Alright.
In order to complete the ritual, you have to grab the fish.
Nope.
Is this one of those things where we each get one try, or can we just take 10?
Try again. Or each of you try.
Try. Each of us try once.
Yep, so you still gotta try.
Alright, weapon finesse would apply to unarmed strikes as well. Because they're technically light weapons. No? Alright. So.
Just roll the d20.
I'm trying to figure it out here. Base attack bonus and strength bonus, so +2. +19.
You catch one of the fish.
You got it!
I do the thing. You put it. The city.
Here's okay. The thing.
Each of you feels like you can maneuver better. You have a +2 to any combat maneuver check for the next 4 hours.
Ooh, cool. What's your character's name?
Atala.
The next was the hunter. The hunter is depicted slaying a giant centipede creature and then parading a trophy through the city streets, a sign that all humanity that the wilds are safe to inhabit once the monsters are slain. Yuri points out that there are centipedes around the edge of the pool. In order to complete this, you must kill one of the centipedes and place it in the city. Place a piece of it in the city.
Okay, Siegfried goes up and goes to stomp on a centipede.
Okay, I need an attack.
How big are the centipedes?
That's
about you big.
That's a pretty darn big centipede.
It certainly is. Oh, that's 13.
It misses, and that was, it turns around and bites at you with a 19 hit?
Yeah.
Okay, you take 1 point of damage.
You said that the first mural was, a fisherman?
Yes.
Seven?
What are you, attack? What are you doing?
Trying to bite it.
Who does a fisherman doing to him, like what?
Let's see. He's hauling an enormous catch of fish back to Absalom.
Alright. I'm gonna draw a little baggie here. I'm gonna draw a little fish on it.
Okay.
And he's...
Would an 18 hit you?
That actually meets my AC.
Okay, so you take 1 point of damage.
Ow!
Alright, this time I just take my sword off my back and try to stab it downward.
Okay.
You're...
That's a 19.
It hits.
That's 7 damage.
You cut it in half.
I grab the piece with the head on it and put it in the city model.
Okay. You have a plus one dodge bonus to AC against charge attacks.
Neat.
What's your character's name?
Siegfried.
Plus two against charge.
Plus one dodge bonus against charge.
Plus one dodge against charge.
The last you saw was the shepherd. He's depicted herding animals out of a crowded city to the pastures beyond, just as Arad and Palesque leaders with foresight to direct people to the task and places the places that best suited them. Yori points out that there are a number of frogs in the pool, and you must clear out the frogs.
I run through the frogs and, like, yell at them.
Either handle animal, intimidate, or wild empathy.
I can intimidate.
Okay.
So can I.
20!
Okay. You scare them out of the city. They all jump out in the pool. And each of you is blessed with an insight bonus, a plus two insight bonus on a single check made to perform the aid another action in the next 24 hours.
Awesome.
Sorry, what was that?
Plus two bonus on aid another. One check. So, you're done here. Yori says, perhaps you should check out, or go investigate that final tunnel and see what's there.
You mean the one with the kobolds?
Yeah.
Alright.
What's left of the kobolds?
Okay.
Yep. Let's do it.
Alright. So...
Rock their world! Perception! That's low this time. I got a 15.
You don't see anything. As you continue along this passage, you begin to hear the faint sounds of combat. As you continue farther in, you hear a familiar woman's voice, half shouting and half reciting, as the legendary Gregario Vault successfully battled the wild beasts in the deepest reaches of the Moingai Expanse, so shall I defeat you, foul servant of Lamash, too?
I think that's our halfway friend.
As you travel through the tunnels, you continue to hear the sounds of the distant combat echoing through the caves, intermixed with inspirational tales of famous Pathfinders and their heroic deeds. You feel inspired by her words and gain a plus one bonus to attack and damage.
I sing along. Does that give a plus two?
I don't know.
Well, if it's the same type of bonus. So
yeah, I wouldn't stack.
Yeah.
Aww.
So, I draw my sword as we continue following the sounds of battle.
Okay.
I get out the sword and put away my guitar. I'm gonna actually have to fight, aren't I?
What do you want to do?
We're going to continue the sound of battle.
I wish I had more room for my map.
Okay, let's see.
I better room for my map. Let me see your map. Jesus! Yeah, you're going to really wish you had more room for your map.
Yeah.
And
it's just a big penis.
Down here.
Great. Which way does the sound of battle seem to be coming from?
In front of you. As you're moving in, tunnel before you move forward. It's still got, you hear the sounds of battle, it's still got the green luminescent junk all over the walls. In front of you, it's also on the floor.
Cool.
You may continue now.
I take a sample.
Okay.
I'm going to...
And kind of smear it on my notes.
I'm going to go right to there to see how the tunnels open up.
When you get right to there, the floor moves and attacks you.
Shut!
Seven would not hit.
No.
What? Right. Deadly ooze of death! Oh, wait, I'm fighting.
Yeah. Oh my god! There's a song title in that!
Alright.
Electrocuted.
So.
Deadly ooze of death!
Deadly ooze of death! Deadly ooze of death! Deadly ooze of death! We have to sew him back together! Oh my god! There's a song title in that!
Stolen back together!
And so. You see a giant slime mold move.
Oh, man. Shit.
As long as it's not a gelatinous cube. Oh, initiative.
Yep, need initiative.
Nat 20! Nat 20!
That's an 8 for me, and you're definitely not being used the rest of the night.
14.
Guitar and get out the sword.
I was playing my sword. Thank you very much.
Okay, so first up is Keone.
I stab it.
You're not in range.
Oh, I'm not in range. I still have flare burst, right? Wait, is that actually going to do anything? That's not fire.
Nope.
No. Dang it. That's like...
Light.
Light. Okay, that won't work. Is there any room where I could step without stepping in the ooze?
You can move up in front of it.
Okay. Like, up here.
No, you have to move right in front of Siegfried.
Okay.
And as you move in... It reaches out and attacks you. Does a 14 hit?
No.
Okay.
I stab it.
Okay.
How do I do that? Wait, I know this. I know this.
Useful for something.
Well, I can't really attack considering that it's single file.
It's, we'll say it's here.
Alrighty.
So,
excuse me.
There is room.
There's room. But first round, so you only have move or standard. So you can move up to it, but you can't attack it.
I'll move up.
I'll let you move up and attack, didn't I?
Yeah.
Oh, well. Okay.
Well, I'll move up, but Siegfried, I want you in that spot next to Keone, alright?
Yeah.
Okay, so next up is the slime. It lunges forward at Keone. Need a reflex save.
I suddenly feel like I'm in a hentai. Oh, nat 20!
Okay. It misses you.
That dice just got two 26. Not in a row. But
next
still.
Up is Siegfried.
So even if I take a 5-foot step, I can't do my touch of destiny on anybody.
Is it full round? Or
touch of destiny is marked as a standard action.
Okay, yeah, you can do it.
Because since I can't attack this round, what I'll do
is... You can attack. You can 5-foot step and attack.
Well, in that case, then, yeah, I'll 5-foot step, and since I don't know what we're dealing with here, I'm going to go ahead and rage. And attack it. And that's... 14 to hit.
Hits it.
Awesome. And it's 2d6 plus 6. That's 15 damage.
Alright. Pieces of it fall to the floor. Keone.
I stab it again. Fourteen?
Hits it.
Yes! 5?
Collapses.
In that case, I drop my rage.
Alright.
Did I just kill it?
Yes.
Waffles yes! for the bard!
Yes! I get waffles!
Yes, it was trying to engulf you.
Yeah!
So, not so much of a hentai, more of Attack on Titan.
Yeah!
Okay. So...
Such a disturbing...
As you continue, you notice a faint light at the end of the tunnel. The sound of Janeiro's oration is close and clear. When you reach the end, the light of the surface world above provides a welcome reprieve from the blue and green fungus of the caverns below, and the light illuminates a stream whose water is hastened by a runoff from a recent storm farther up the mountains. A ledge to the west rises up to the nearby forest canopy. Leaving you now. When you look down south, you see Janeiro and the Minotaur. She's clearly not done well. She should be right here. See her take her whip and attempt to disarm it. She fails to do that.
Well, it's going to take
steps back and throws a Tanglefoot bag at it, which misses it. I'll roll for it. Yeah, it misses it. She sees you then and screams, "Help me!"
Running is quadruple your speed, right?
Yes. The Minotaur, before you can do anything, is going to step up, take a swing at her, or it's going to attempt to gore her and misses.
So I would be able to get see how deep the river is from here.
Yes. The river is 10 feet wide, about 5 feet deep. It's moving about 30 feet per round.
So the surface is long.
All of these little spots here are trees. So keep that in mind.
It would be possible if you were running and getting quadruple speed to get there.
The log is very moist, so you'd only be able to move at half speed on it.
And that would probably, yeah.
It's going to take us a couple turns to get to her. This isn't going to be a one-and-done deal. So, we can definitely run to
the log. Roll initiative.
Okay. That's a 15 for me. Guys, I'm pretty sure that this is the fight where we need to actually use team strategy instead of our usual everybody attack.
What was 16?
15.
26.
17.
Do remember that my Touch of Destiny gives a bonus to ability to pretty much everything. That includes abilities and skills. So if anybody feels that they don't have the base skill necessary to cross a slippery log, I can give you at least one more point to do that.
Acrobatics would be for crossing the log?
Yes.
Yeah, I got that. Do her.
My acrobatics wearing my armor is a negative 2, so it's going to be fun for me.
Okay, so first up is Atala.
And running gives quadruple speed, just to quadruple clarify.
Yes.
It means I have 120 feet to work with.
By crossing the log.
How far can you throw?
Throw?
Yeah, like a potion.
I would say that would be, it might be 10 feet.
No. Oh. So I wouldn't be able to throw it over the river and hit the Minotaur.
You want to hit the Minotaur with a potion?
Well, Alchemist Fire.
So that would be, let's see, that would be 70 feet to get there, and then assuming I succeed at my roll, that would be 40 feet to get across the log, so.
You can't sprint to it, take a short, or move at half speed and then move after.
Okay. How difficult does the stream look to swim across?
It would be pretty tough.
Alright.
30 feet per round, that's pretty much, and each round is 6 seconds, so every 6 seconds it's going 30 miles.
Alright, so.
So that thing's actually moving pretty fast, if you think about it.
Alright. Well,
30 miles? Every 6 seconds?
Oh, 30 feet. 30 feet.
Okay, I was about to say.
30 feet for every 6 seconds.
I have it on the selector icon, but I have no control over it.
Oh, sorry.
I'm not able to select mine either.
Alright.
Let me fix that real quick.
So, he's clearly making it so that we can't get to her in one round. This is going to take us a round just to get to the log, and then a round just to cross the log.
What would it be to taunt?
Intimidate.
So like I said, I have a way to make everybody give a bit more of a chance to cross the log successfully.
I'm pretty good at acrobatics. I don't think I'm going to have trouble with the log.
True. But I'm wearing medium armor, so I'm taking penalties acrobatics. I'm not sure about Atala.
I'm good.
Okay.
I was thinking I could run to the edge of the river and try and taunt the Minotaur and at least distract him while you guys get over there.
Now, is the halfling playing her song?
She uses oratory, so she is still continuing to.
So we're all getting plus ones.
Yes.
To our roles and stuff.
Yes.
All right.
So what I'm not as good at is intimidating.
Let us remember the sacrifice of the fabled Yasmin Dittborough, favorite of the Tant, who gave her life to striking Cerambarus, the draconic scourge of the society so dozens of junior agents could survive. Her act of benevolence is the epitome of cooperation within the society.
Alright. So.
So I could use your touch for that.
I'm gonna use
it only lasts for one round, so I'm gonna need you to follow us to the log in order for me to use it on.
I can only use my move foot to move up to the log, so. Okay.
And with that, she looks, she sounds like her voice is giving out on it.
Oh no!
Hey,
oh no!
Do you mind Dad pick you up tonight?
Yes, I want him over here tonight. I think I still have my old character sheet, so he can play the spear whatever.
I don't know how long it takes him to get here.
So.
You'd like Dave. Dave's a cool guy. He's the dwarf of our group.
Oh.
As in, he talks and acts like a dwarf would.
Yeah, pretty much. Okay. And usually plays a dwarf.
Next up, Keone.
Okay, I follow because he said to follow.
Yeah.
So, and I'm... I hate how this works.
Pretty much follow... Yeah. After I give you the touch of destiny, what you're going to do is move a bit down the bank so that when he notices you, he doesn't also see us.
Can you make an action and then run?
Well, you're able to move 30 feet regularly, right?
Yeah, but I'm making my action now. I could hold. Huh?
It's still the first round for y'all, so you can move or take an action.
And quadruple moving is a full round action anyway, so you would be done as... So, and then I
so
just...
So we all just move to the lock.
Yeah.
Yep.
What's going to happen the next turn is, I'm going to want you to hold your action since you go before me.
Okay.
I'm going to touch a destiny you. You're going to immediately move whatever your full amount of regular moving speed is, 30 feet or whatever, down the bank, and then make your intimidation roll.
The range from the edge of the log to the Minotaur, alright, let's hold on just a sec. If Keone were right here, and we were right here, would we still be within range of her song?
Yeah.
Alright, so, here's what I'm thinking.
Mm-hmm.
I use Aid Another on,
Siegfried.
On Siegfried.
Plus get, 4 instead of the plus 2.
Plus one.
So plus four instead of plus two. Because of the bonus.
So I use aid another action on him so that he can he crosses the log. You use aid another on...
You wouldn't be able to assist him with that.
I won't be able to? Alright. God damn it.
What?
I was thinking we just use aid another, leave her on the other side so that she can still boost us with the song.
No.
Alrighty. Gonna have to do this the hard way then.
Let's see.
Direction.
And she is going to...
I think we're going to need that aid another in order to fight the guy, though.
Attempt to jump over the river. And she's just too exhausted to ever make it.
Shit.
And lands in the river.
Oh boy! I don't think we have to worry about the Minotaur right now!
The Minotaur's up. And she runs. It follows her. And moves. She'll be out of reach of it. It moves into the river. And loses its balance and just has to stop right where it's at. So that's all it can do.
I broke, right?
Next up is Cleric. And then Atala.
Alright.
Now we got our halfling and the minotaur struggling in the river.
Does a bard kit have rope in it?
Yes.
Okay.
Let's see. 20 feet. So I could move 20 feet, 10 feet, and then be within range to attack the Minotaur, yes? I moved 20 feet there, and then moved 10 feet.
Yes.
Alright, so that's what I'm going to do.
Okay.
Boop, boop. I'm going to use both attacks. Gonna unload both barrels on them.
You'd only be able to do...
Oh, one time. Okay, yep. I got you. That's a 6 plus 6, 12.
Does not hit.
All right.
If you're planning on doing anything, hold your action right now, because I'm still thinking I should touch a destiny you to add power to whatever it is you're going to do.
Get out a rope and try and fish our halfling friend out.
Exactly.
So I hold my action?
Yeah, just hold your action so I go before you instead of after you.
Okay.
Basically, you'd be going on 14.
Okay.
So...
I hold my action until after he touches me in weird places.
Okay.
So.
Only that fully described, please.
Well, that's for him to describe how he touches
please
me.
Please don't.
He just wants you, not anybody else, because when he thinks about you, he touches himself.
That's an actual song. You gotta watch House of Powers.
I just want you.
Okay.
Anyway.
Keone is holding action. So that means Siegfried's up.
Alright, so Siegfried's gonna give Keone a pat on the shoulder and activate his Touch of Destiny on her.
Okay. Keone's up.
Okay. I run over and get out my rope and try and fish her out.
Okay, give me,
Wait, do they have a use rope check, or was that just in 3.5?
That's nope. Just in
3.5. Dick.
Thank God, too.
Okay, we'll call it a combat maneuver, so...
Oh, I get a bonus on that, right?
Yep, plus 2.
Yay!
And you still get my plus 1.
How do I... That's a CMB, right?
Yep.
Yeah, 0. Great.
Well,
3.
That's right. Jeez! 7! Okay. She grabs for the rope.
Doesn't the rope have any, like, bonuses to it? Like, that I'm actually using a rope instead of just trying to grab her?
Nope.
Great.
And she misses it.
Great.
Alright, your plus 1 goes away.
Because
it only lasts for 1 round.
So she grabs for it and misses, and then loses her footing and she gets swept 30 feet downriver.
Wait, is she going into the caves?
No.
Oh.
The Minotaur...
you have a better combat maneuver, right?
You.
that's not really one of my concerns right now with the Minotaur. Right,
and he tries to gore you and fails.
You have a better combat maneuver, right?
I like this right here. Yes?
Better than zero. Get her!
You want me, your DPS guy, and probably your one with the highest AC, to leave you two alone with the Minotaur?
The cleric goes and tries.
You think she's going to be able to climb out on her own?
As a halfling, no, but...
The cleric gets a rope out to her.
Thank you, cleric!
As Peter Griffin said, oh, there, you see, it solved itself.
Alright, so now, Natalia, you have a Minotaur standing right next to you.
I'm going to unleash both barrels on it.
Okay.
You're going to immediately piss your pants first and unleash both barrels on it.
Is it still in the river?
No, it's out of the river.
Why? Why?
Because God hates you. And by God, I mean GM.
I'm assuming the 10 doesn't hit. But I am assuming that the 24 does.
It does, yes.
All right, so that's 2d4 plus 1. 8 points of damage.
Okay.
Man, if only I could do some other bardic stuff other than just this. Because some of the other bardic stuff is so cool.
Next up is
I need to get to him. I'm not going to try to waste a sound to get flanking. At least not right now. So, moving there and there.
Okay. As you move up, it tries to gore you, and that's a nat 20.
Oh.
So does a 19 hit?
Yeah.
Okay. You take 12 points of damage.
If only I had said I'm raging first. I just dropped to -2 hit points.
Alright.
If I was raging first, I would have only gone down to 0. So, Siegfried is on the ground.
Alright, bleeding.
Yeah.
You got gored as you tried to walk up to it.
Hooray!
Keone.
5 foot step.
The DPS / tank is down.
And I stab it.
You would swing with the longsword.
Okay, well, I swing it.
All right.
Well, I mean, a longsword could stab. 14. If you had, like, a long...
It hits.
If you had, like, a long...
We have pencils on the ground! Suggest the use of eight another's attacks.
Halfling gets out. She's useless. It's now the Minotaur's turn.
You are gonna die!
She's not dead, but she's close.
And then it's almost dead, guys. To here, tries to attack the cleric, and misses.
Natala, do you feel happy?
Next up.
I'm
is...
sorry, I can't understand you when you're trying to speak through your lung.
Having gotten the halfling up, she moves over. Check. And Siegfried is stable.
Hooray!
He has horses?
Yes.
What about, like, Cure Moderate?
Well, she had to get to him.
Oh,
she,
okay.
She doesn't have it. She's level 1.
Oh.
She's not the Uber medic.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, he's stable.
Okay. So, Atala.
Outpost's gonna give you the pecking order.
Why? I'm stupid. Why would she do that? You get 3 hit points back.
Yeah, I was about to say, where's Cure Light Wounds at?
So, he is at...
Any magical curingness!
I'm at 1 hit point right now.
Alright, and you're still prone.
Yes.
Alright, did he make any attacks of opportunity against anyone moving around him? Okay, that's...
me!
That works. So I can move up and over without reprisal.
Correct.
And I want to use aid another on the cleric so that she gets a bonus to her attack against the Minotaur.
Okay.
All right. Because the cleric has been killing people. The bard can at least back up and play her lute so that everyone else can get
Frank, what do you do?
Do I have to make a roll for aid another, or does it just happen?
You can't aid her because she's not attacking. You would have to...
Okay.
You would need a roll. So, roll.
Alright.
Just an attack roll.
So, that'd be... any ability modifiers, or...
Just your regular attack roll.
Alright. That would be a 15.
Okay. So she'll have a +2.
Alright.
Well, and plus he gets a +2 from the ritual.
Did you use that yet?
I have not used that yet.
Okay.
So she gets a +4 on top of the +1 from Keone, I'm assuming?
So she's...
I'm attacking!
Oh, you're attacking.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Okay. Next
I've actually hit him. Oh, I'm next?
You're next.
Oh, I 5-foot?
Oh, wait, I have 9 feet.
That's...
Okay.
You asked me what I want to do.
What do you want to do?
Standing is a full round action, right?
No, it's a standard action that does provoke attacks of opportunity, but...
He hasn't made his other move, so I can stand up safely. So I'm going to stand up safely, and I'm going to enter rage to get another 2 temporary hit points. Okay, now Keone.
At 5 foot.
You stood up. Okay, so standing up's a move action.
Oh.
Standard. Okay. So you still have a standard action if you would like to.
Yes, I would, because... I've been rolling shit for attack, and I don't want to put too much attention on me. So, standing, free to go into rage. Keone's going next, so she gets Touch of Destiny again. Go for it.
Okay.
5 foot. / 19 +3.
It hits.
+4.
Does that fall within the critical range?
Sword is a crit.
Yep. Woo! So how do I do that?
Roll again to confirm.
No.
Okay, so it's not a crit, but it does hit.
Okay. 6.
Okay.
And the +1 for me is gone.
She 7? Just lays there.
Was that +1 for damage?
No, just attack.
Okay. Cool.
The halfling just lays on the ground.
I'm not dead yet.
Are there red numbers?
She's alive, she's just exhausted.
Okay, so there aren't any red numbers above her head?
No.
Okay.
So the Minotaur is going to attack.
If we die in the game, we die in real life.
The cleric and going to miss. And then he's going to try and gore Atala. miss?
No.
All right.
It's not.
So he misses. The cleric is going to attack. 14 hits. She does 3 damage. Next up is Atala.
I'm going to attack with both. So. A 12, does that hit?
That's not.
Alright, so neither would the other attack.
Siegfried.
I'm not gonna dare try and fight it, so I'm just gonna hold my ground and make an attack. Oh, shit. 17?
Is it?
Awesome. So 12 points of damage.
Alright. Next up is... healing.
Could I do a... acrobatics to, like, get behind it?
Yes.
Very nice. Do it.
I'm gonna do that. How do I do that?
Just make your acrobatics check.
Roll an acrobatics check against his CMD. So I'll need to look that up real quick.
Oh, fuck.
13.
Good idea, but considering it's a minotaur, it might not work out.
Nope. And so...
Fall in the river?
No, you'll just stay where you're at and it gets an attack opportunity on you.
It was a good idea, though. Something that needed to be done.
Yep.
18 hits.
Yes! Dang it.
You take 5 points of damage.
Okay, not dead yet.
Halfling just lays there like a little bitch.
What's your acrobatics look like?
My acrobatics is 5, but that's all for my ability. I have no score.
Minotaur does withdraw action, moves through the river, makes a strength check, and runs off. Goodbye, Minotaur.
We don't get an attack on him?
No. Not on a withdraw action.
Okay.
It ran?
Yes.
That was a hell of a thing.
By all accounts, he won!
Yes.
Hey.
Do,
are you okay?
Okay, so Claire goes over and...
So...
Heals?
Yes.
So,
heals, please.
So I drop my rage back down to 1 hit point, and I'm like, okay, now the pain is starting to set in.
Yeah, I'm bleeding.
So are we all healed back up to full? Or...
Well, you're down, so it doesn't really matter.
Okay.
Let's see. So, the engineer says, oh, thank you so much for saving my life. I just never could. Get up on it, or get one up on it.
Well,
it just kept coming at me.
The odd thing is that we really didn't beat it. It kind of ran off on its own.
That's fine. It was almost too powerful for us anyway.
Well, what would make it run off like that?
You hurt it significantly.
It didn't really feel like we were doing too much.
They may not be all that intelligent, but they do. Have a survival instinct. So now that we're not under threat, what did you find in the cave?
Tons!
Alright.
We hand our notes over. Simultaneously. She is bombarded with paper.
Whoa.
Ow!
Paper cut!
Mom's unconscious.
Well, now you've done it, Atala. You just had to make that intricate map.
It was very intricate.
Sorry.
No, this is good.
Okay, so. You rest up the rest of the day, late the next day to head back to Absalom. No further incidents. So you head back to the Grand Lodge, where you are met by the Master of Scrolls, Great Shane. Well, hello! Welcome back! I see you've had a bit of an experience, it appears.
We survived!
May I see your notes?
Ah, baby, God!
This is quite good. Your notes are very good.
You haven't even looked at them yet.
Yeah, well. Yeah, no. I see. I mean, I know what you were writing. So that's, like, really freaking detailed math.
Hey, what can I say?
Split amongst three box sets.
Yeah.
They finally put it into one big rule book.
So they finally did what they should have done in the first place?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so.
Sorry.
Yes, it's good that you wrote everything down there. It's hard enough to remember what one had for breakfast the day before, much less recall what you saw while studying an incantation days earlier. Well, excellent. And now it would seem, as no one else has explored these caves, that the three of you are the foremost authorities. Would you care to name the cave?
Name the cave?
George.
Well, I think that considering its importance to the Gilman, they should be the ones to name it.
Excellent. All right.
You mean we're not going to name it George?
No.
Janeiro, thank you for assisting them in their task. Janeiro just beams. Let's see. So, you rest up. 3 days later, you finish your confirmation. You are brought in as full Pathfinder field agents during the ceremony. Marcus, whatever his name is, Proletaris, whatever, the Master of Swords presents Atala and Siegfried with a wayfinder that's personalized with their initials. And Master Shane gives Keone one, also with her initials on it.
You'll want to take off that lone sword and ring because we have to give them more.
And the Cloak of Resistance.
Well, you lost that when we first met the Gilman. We were like, hey, this thing is yours.
These wayfinders serve as a reminder to you of the three principal duties of a Pathfinder: to explore, report, and cooperate. Let's see. You open the primary, you finish secondary. What time is it? 10 o'clock. So, real quick,
I'll heal up.
Yep. Looks at Siegfried and says, now that that's complete, you, come with me. There's somebody who wants to talk to you. And so he takes Siegfried down, back into the Grand Lodge, and they go down into the basements, or into the vaults there. He says, in there.
Very well.
All right. So, you go in, and you see sitting inside, if it'll load, Paracountess Zarda Drawine.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
She has cleavage.
She does, yes.
She kind of reminds me of Raven in a more adult way.
Welcome.
So, this, only he's seeing
just
this?
Seen.
Alrighty.
Welcome, Pathfinder. Congratulations on your confirmation on, and on being the full field agents.
Eyes locked onto her eyes. Even though I'm sure he's standing slightly taller than her, so we don't have to look down.
Yes, she's sitting, you're standing.
And,
you're standing in more ways than one. Let's just be thankful you are wearing a tin suit, not sweatpants.
Who might I be talking to, and where am I?
I am the Paracountess Zarda Drawine. Drawine. Yeah, she stumbles over her own last name. Zarda Drawine.
Just call me Zarda D. Everyone else does it.
The Countess of what, exactly?
I am the, primary curator for the Dark Archives of the Pathfinder Society. I believe, since your mentor Zaid is a member as well, that you're familiar with us.
Yes, he spoke of you every now and then.
I would like to invite you to join us. I believe you would be an excellent addition.
Considering the kind of training he gave me and what he's told me of you, I believe I would like to be a part of this as well.
Excellent. We will be glad to have you with us. Now, unfortunately, I have much to do, so we won't be able to talk, but we will soon.
All right, then.
And so you leave. Set on your two factions that you said.
The Silver Lodge is basically the
Silver Crusade.
Silver Crusade, but that's basically the good guys.
They're just the good guys. Yeah.
Freeing slaves!
Okay.
Whatever that was.
I'm part of the top men that the Ark of the Covenant was given to, pretty much.
So, you go to visit Atala, goes to visit the Temple of the Shining Star in Absalom.
Does it serve any particular god, or is it just...
Surrendering.
Alright.
You're not necessarily there for...
That reason.
Yeah. But... while there... You are approached by Olista Zadran. She's a badass paladin.
Cool.
Paladin.
She says, pardon me. Are you Atala?
Yes.
Excellent. Congratulations on your confirmation into the Pathfinder Society.
Thank you.
I am Olista Zadran. Wouldn't know me, most likely. I'm the leader of the Silver Crusade.
Yes, I believe I've heard about you.
Excellent. We are looking for recruits. People who wish to see good done in the land. We model ourselves after the Silver Dragon. Making a valiant effort to use the Society's influence, reach, and resources to do good throughout the Inner Sea region and beyond. We're always in need of strong arms to assist in that. Would you be interested?
Well, what I want to do is fight. What I want to do is fight monsters, and why I want to do it is for the right reasons. So,
excellent.
I would be interested.
Excellent. Fighting the forces of evil is—it sounds cliche, but it's our primary purpose. So yes, we would be very honored to have you. Okay, so that one done.
I am chowing down.
All right.
Cashing in on some free food.
Okay.
And good company.
So, you're sitting in the bar, eating.
Yep.
Gravy and biscuits and...
Wait, with like...
Dumplings,
biscuits,
chicken.
Are biscuits on the gravy or gravy on the biscuits?
Both.
Okay. Just like get a bowl of gravy and you just like put biscuits on it.
And under it and... Mix it all up.
And this guy walks in and sits down next to you.
Hi.
Hello. I'm Major Coulson Maldris of the Andorran Eagle Knights.
Okay.
Are you Keone?
Yes, how did you know?
Well, I'm very involved in the Pathfinder Society. Saw that you were recently inducted.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'll be very direct. I'm the head of Liberty's Edge. You most likely won't have heard of us. We like to keep our actions somewhat discreet.
Okay.
Our purpose... is to help others throw off the shackles of tyranny and bring freedom to all people.
So you overthrow governments?
Well, yes. The tyrannical governments of some lands we work towards. We have quite a strong army in the Pathfinder Society of people willing to step out. But sometimes, it's not always the best way to handle things. Sometimes, a good word is an excellent way to move people in the direction you want.
I agree.
I sought you out because I'm looking for people who would be able to exert influence. Not necessarily in a martial way, but in a more subtle way to bring about our goals.
I think I could help.
Excellent. All right, well, I'll be contacting you then.
Cool.
Thank you.
But discreetly.
Discreetly, yes. Thank you. And he leaves. Okay. And that's that.
Yay!
So this wayfinder you have is a compass.
How much does it weigh?
Don't worry about it. And it's, but it also has the ability to give off light at a command word of your choosing, whatever you want.
So. Sword of Owens, give me Scipion's sight.
I was going to go Sith Boy.
One word. One word.
Oh, so now I'm Sith Boy.
God. Alright.
Okay. I do not have the sheets.
Well, that's
stupid
good.
Stupid printers still don't work.
Sound like your son had the sheets.
Oh, yeah.
That's an inside joke for us, listeners.
let's see. But you earned...
Oh, we
earn stuff.
Yes.
Cool.
Shit, we earn shit.
More stuff. Where'd my pencil go?
You had a pencil.
It was yours.
Oh.
Oh, there it is.
By the way, we'll check Facebook.
Huh?
Remember when I said something about there being a re-release of Fallouts 1 and 2 and whatnot?
I think I saw about that. It like came out like the nuclear shell package.
Are we still recording?
Yeah.
Yeah, we all.
Stop recording then.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Right. Bye.
Get the hell out of here.
Good night.